This is Nico B, back with some more Danganronpa 3, The End of Hopespeak Academy. We last left off, our favorite purple hair detective died a fucking painful death, which was really, really predictable. Even, you know, even if you guys hadn't, like, sort of spoiled it by saying, oh, shit happens in this episode, like, they raised so many death flags, because they're just being like, no matter what happens, you know, assuming I don't get poisoned in the next 5 minutes. It's like, remember, I will always be with you. Sure, I'm sure there's no reason for her to be saying that. Just go to sleep. Danganronpa, I feel like, usually is the kind of story that will throw unexpected deaths at you a lot of times. So I will say, I found it rather strange that they had sort of set it up so obviously like that. But actually, as a lot of you guys have pointed out, there may be this distinct possibility that she isn't really dead. Some of you guys said you thought you saw, like, an antidote bottle, that one that Seiko had. You thought you saw an empty one in the corner. I looked through it. I couldn't find what you guys were talking about, but I do believe you guys believe it's there. So it could be that she took that antidote before that she got infected. Maybe she's still alive. I'll be perfectly honest though. I mean, I love Kigiri and I would have preferred that they didn't kill her, you know, but now that they have, I honestly would rather they didn't just be like, oh, she's really alive and bring her back again. Just because they've already pulled this shit on us already, you know, with Ashina. It's like, oh god, one of your favorite beloved characters is dead, and oh, no, just kidding. You should see the look on your stupid fucking face. I feel like once, okay, funny. The second time, it's just kind of like, I don't know, it's kind of insulting, I feel like. So while I love Kigiri, I don't know, it would just feel a little bit like a cop-out, like, oh, I'm just kidding again. You know, they just pull her back. I don't know, it just seems kind of like bad writing, in my opinion, if they do that. If, honestly, if they hadn't done that with Ashina already, I'd be like, okay, I totally want to, I'd be fine with that. But they did, so it's just kind of like, I don't know. I do have my criticisms of this anime. There's a lot of things I like, but there's also a number of things I really haven't liked so much, you know? Mostly revolving around how they handled Monica and stuff like that. But yes, when we last left off in the Despair arc, Kameda got himself fucking bitch slapped by Izuru. Actually, no, he didn't. No, he got shot right in the tit. Oh, and you guys said apparently when he saw like Izuru in that like multicolored, like it was like hippie trippy dippy going on, that was like him essentially like falling in love with Izuru. Yeah, when I went back to watch, I was like, oh, I didn't even realize that he sort of like blushed when he fell down. Like, oh, he's so beautiful. Someone with as much bullshit as me, I didn't think it was possible. Oh, the fangirls are just like, I need this! But it does also raise some questions, because didn't he say when he was on the boat with Izuru that was the first time meeting each other? It could be that maybe their memories get erased. Maybe when they get turned to ultimate despair, they forget some of who they were. I don't know, honestly. But hopefully they explain that, because that would seem like a pretty big plot hole. Or maybe Kameda just didn't get a good glimpse of him. All I could see was a big wave of black and Izuru's giant dick just swinging around. So anyway, now Yukizome is going down into the pit to face off with Junko, and I don't know, I'm a little nervous. I'm a little nervous that Ryota might already have, like, been brainwashed or something, and maybe lure her down there. Spare Arc Episode 9, let's get started. Oh, that's right, of course. I forgot, Jackie ran to her husbando again. Oh god, just get over there and make out with him, and then that suddenly turns him back to Hajime. He's like, oh my god, what have I been doing this whole time? And then just fucking sucker punches the shit out of Junko. Oh, best ending ever. That's your first question. What happened to your hair? Really? Not where have I been all this time? Well, I have awesome demon power. Why I'm hanging out with this crazy bitch? Oh, the hair. Yeah. Be honest, that's actually the one thing I don't know. I have no idea why I have my hair like this. Because those Future Foundation people were fucking weirdos. I didn't think you'd remember her, unfortunately.
Whoa, I thought she just ran over and just started kissing Giacchio.
Okay, well, my brain says no, but my body says yes.
She, are you checking me out? What was that?
Oh, Yukizome's coming out with a fire extinguisher! Boo! Oh! Oh, damn it, she missed. Oh, shit. She's just staying behind? No, Yukizome, no! Well, I mean, you don't die, I don't think. Right?
You know, we saw Kigiri examining Yukizome's body a few episodes ago in the future arc. I was trying to think, what did she discover there? We never really explained yet. But could it be that maybe that isn't really Yukizome? Maybe that's not, like, really her body? Because you guys pointed out a few things. One, you pointed out that there appears to be an extra person. Like, if you count up all the people remaining, it was 9 people or something at some point, and but there was one extra person that we haven't taken into account. So maybe there's like a hidden member or something we don't know about, and that's the person. That person's the killer. I forgot. I also made the mistake last episode. Yukizome's dead, therefore Murakami's be fake. She didn't die by the wristwatch. It wasn't like her rule got violated. She died from the killer. So yeah. So that's probably really Munakata. Sorry, a bit of a brain fart there. But it does seem like there might be somebody else there. I hope it's not like Zero Escape. He was in the room with you the whole fucking time. He just couldn't see because of the weird camera angles. Wow, really? Chico's like,
yeah, you know what? I'm just going to fucking tell you. Because I guess it's not going to make any fucking difference, right?
Hey, it's me, Hajime. I'm super sexy and talented now. Uh-oh. The last day you and your class will remain yourselves. Ah, fuck. It's coming to a head here. So they're just going to run to a trap, I guess. But the thing was, we know Chiaki doesn't show up in the, I guess, the group that they brought to the island on Danganronpa 2, right? So, like, what happens to her? Is she going to die?
Ah, yes, good. I can unleash my deadly hamsters. They shall feast on her rotting flesh.
Do you ever take a second to, like, listen to yourself?
The funny thing is, I feel like really haven't seen Izuru do anything with despair yet, other than like just kind of rolling with Junko, what Junko's been doing. I mean, he shot Kameda, I guess. He hasn't actually been going around and been like,
oh yeah, I've got a hard on for despair and shit.
Oh no. Hey, Yukizome, maybe she run over there and I don't know, smack the shit out of her. I mean, I know Izuru's probably stop you, but still, come on. Oh shit, it's Blue Hajime. Oh fucking hell.
Ew, dude, stop cutting your jello head off.
This school really needs to start screening their students better.
Ah, fuck!
You know, that was disgusting, but it was also kind of impressive. I mean, seriously, like, I don't know. I feel like at some point, he would have passed out, but he managed to get his head all the way off before he did that. Good on you, man.
That includes you, which makes me worry that if she is, then maybe she ends up being, like, the mastermind or something, and she really is alive in the future arc.
It would explain that sort of fourth wall breaking moment where she was like, oh, look, I died, right?
Oh, wow. Look at Kameda having a smart idea for once.
Ah, no. Chiaki, don't do it.
Chiaki's too full of fucking hope. That hope's gonna fuck him in the end.
We never would have played Smash Brothers together. And Akane wouldn't have thrown her boobs in my face.
Oh, snap, crackle, pop.
Behold, the real Fat Tagami.
Oh, god damn it.
I was wondering if we were ever gonna see what your real face looked like.
You look like a really fat Zack Fair.
Oh my god, he ripped his face off.
He's dead, I ate him. No, I'm just kidding, Nico. See, I am being a nugget. I just want to see everyone's bright, shining, erect hopes. All right. Time for Kameda to go get a girly arm. Oh, no, I'm not hurt. It's just really hard for me to stand with this raging erection I have.
Yes, Masarni, I'll do whatever the hell you tell me to do.
Nekomaru ready to shit on the competition.
This is not going to end well.
Notes, admission by recommendation by the board of directors is a special case, but the board guarantees their talent. As such, admission to the 70th class is approved. Principal Jin Kiyaguri and Scout Koichi Kizukura must not involve themselves in this decision. As the principal oversees students after admission, the board bears no responsibility.
Oh yeah, this chick seems crazy as shit. Let's bring her here. I mean, I guess she's probably, it's like, oh, she's the ultimate super fashionista. But I don't know, has anyone else have been noticing how every place she ends up going to ends up with a lot of dead people and grenades being tossed out windows?
I have a feeling the reason that Munakata killed Juzo was because he did something here. He failed to do something. He probably didn't think Munakata knew about it. Or maybe Munakata found out about it somehow during the future arc. Either, like, fail to save Yukizome, and maybe that's not the real Yukizome we've been seeing, or... But I'm pretty sure that sometime soon we're gonna see whatever his failure was, and probably the reason Munakata killed him.
Alright, well, you're fucked. I will put your boobs on a mantle.
Oh, fucking hell. Oh, she's forcing her eyes open.
No! Break free, Yukizome! Use your ultimate maid powers to sweep her under the rug!
Oh, what the fuck? Ew, what the fuck is she doing? She's, like, stabbing her brain? Oh, god.
Oh, fuck.
Shut up, Izuru.
Ooh, that was rough. They always have to be playing the weird fucking music every time they're doing fucked up shit.
Wait, so she managed to just kind of take a pin and just kind of put it in her head like that, right through the fucking skull, without any kind of hammer or anything? And somehow that worked?
It must be that Yukizome is, I'm betting, the mastermind then, right?
I was wondering, because remember how I was saying at the beginning of this, I was seeing that we saw in the intro, like, the silhouette, this like expanded hair flowing behind her. And I was thinking maybe that meant that Yukizome is evil. And I was like, oh, well, no, she seems pretty legit to me. But I think it is. I think it is suggesting that this is what happened. And that she got turned into this. I don't know. I don't know if she's pretending to be dead or if that wasn't really her that died.
We oppose the scholarship system. Give us a chance. Equal education.
Oh, it's the reserve course. There's that little uprising I was... Oh, fuck.
Shit on him, Nikamaru!
Oh! Oh! Oh, the hamsters!
12 Zodiac hamsters!
Run, Ryota, run!
Oh, fucking hell. Wow. Wow, you guys sure formed a perfect circle fast. Oh, shit. Strangle the fuck out of her.
Do it, Ryota!
Fuck me, poor Ryota. Fuck you, Junko. Crazy psycho slut. I hope at least before she goes, like, leaves here, that he just manages to at least get, like, one solid punch in her fucking face. Just give me that. Nope. She's just gonna run away like a little pussy. Fuck.
Oh, here we go. It's time to duel, bitch.
Okay. I sort of see what's going on here. So, there's, like, a moment last episode where they were talking about Nagi and how hopeful he was, and I saw Ryota, like, clench his fist, and I thought he was... Because he was just like, oh, I'm so fucking sick of hearing this shit because I'm one of the despair people or something. But no, it's because he did that. It's because of this. Because he feels like he's let everybody down. The whole reason that everyone fell into despair was because of what he did. So he's just beating himself up about it. So hearing how great Nagi is, he's sort of thinking what a failure he feels like he's been. So it's gotta be Yukizome then, who's, yeah, one of the remnants of despair and probably the mastermind. I do hope that Ryota gets some redemption at some point, you know? I like to think he will. Aw. I do feel really bad for Ryota.
Jesus, this is not gonna end well for you, bro.
Yes, I knew my ability as the ultimate code hacker would finally pay off. So when exactly did, like, Junko capture all the Reserve Course students and brainwash them? Well, nice that they kind of showed that at some point. I mean, that seems like a pretty big undertaking to get every single one of the students... brainwashed.
Yeah, this is never gonna happen, is it?
Jackie.
You're making my insides hurt.
Oh, shit. Tsumiki's already bananas.
Fuck! Fuck you, Tsumiki! Don't tell me you fucking killed Chiaki!
Oh, shit.
No. She's already demon evil.
Chisa Yukizome doesn't smile. Side Despair Episode 9. What? What is that supposed to mean? Is that like, it's not like this is the first time she's ever smiled before. Or are we saying that she's just not smiling in that scene or something? Not really smiling. But it's already been fucking brainwashed. So we know whatever it ends up being, it's not good.
Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, the next one's gonna be bad. Really bad. And I feel like this is not gonna end well for Jackie. I don't know, maybe she's gonna just witness then everyone getting turned to despair, and then, like, then they're gonna kill her or something. I don't think she's gonna survive this, though. But this does tell us then, very likely, then, the mastermind of the future arc is probably Yukizome, right? That really wasn't her dead body. A lot of you guys thought, and I kind of started to think this possibly too, it seemed like maybe Ryota had actually killed herself. I think some of you pointed out that it seems like in every room where somebody dies, there's a monitor in that room. So maybe it's that the killer is always the person who dies, essentially. Maybe. I can't actually honestly see Ryota's being anybody else but her. You know, she barricaded herself in that room, but also the fact that she had sort of like had all those candies like everywhere jammed in her mouth, you know, like unless somebody grabbed her candies and did that, you know, I don't think so. And not to mention just how brutal it really was. It was a lot like what Kameda did to himself in Danganronpa 2. So it might be then that the killers really are just, they're brainwashed by like whatever video is shown up on the monitor. And they off themselves, essentially. That's my theory, at least. Ugh, we do know that this next despair arc is not gonna be fun. It's not gonna be good. Ugh, that scene where they were brainwashing Yukizome was really, that was hard to watch. That was, just don't really get how taking two needles to the brain would kind of fuck up your sense of thinking. But then again, probably shouldn't think about it too much because there's a whole lot of other shit that just doesn't make any sense in this. But so I should probably just suspend my disbelief by this point. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Like for if you did, subscribe now, become Peak Penguin aboard the SLP, where the days are always sunny and the vids are always funny. All right, I'll be officially caught up after the next future arc here. So woo,
fuck yeah, finally.
It only took till like the last couple of episodes. Yes, I saw that they had a trailer for Danganronpa V3 and it looks fucking awesome. It turns out he plays a girl, not the robot we all thought we'd be. But anyway, as always guys, till next time, stay classy.